It's Adriel, the hunting gear guy. Today I've got a Browning X-Bolt. This one's in 7mm Remington Magnum. I wanted to show you guys a couple of features on it. I've had the written review on my website for quite a while now, and wanted to do a video one. So, just talking overall for the rifle, this is getting a little bit more pricier than a typical Savage or even some of the Remingtons. But you get a couple of things with that. You get a nice rubberized stock. It's got kind of like a rubbery, almost sticky feel to it that they call their Dura-Touch armor coating. And you kind of get a couple of really nice features and nice little touches on it. I'm just going to zoom us in here. Kind of show the bolt. Come on. There she goes. The bolt is a three-lug design, and generally with a three-lug design, you get a smaller bolt lift. With a two-lug, you're looking at 90 degrees. With a six-lug, you're usually generally looking at 60 degrees. So you have no problems with scope clearance on something like this, and that's kind of handy, right? The bolt's actually pretty smooth. I know this you can hear a lot in here, but compared to something like a Remington 770, this is the bee's knees. Lockup is nice and secure, and this bolt and this action on this rifle is very accurate as well. Onto the features for this thing. At the back here, we've got a tang safety. I love the tang safety. I don't think they should be anywhere else, simply because when my hand's on the trigger, it's easy to grab that with a thumb that's just up on the tang here, whereas on the side, sometimes you got to reach. With this design, you don't have to. It's pretty good. I don't know if you can see here, but there's actually a, let me just get us a little bit closer on there. There's a little protruding thing here, and that's because when you put it on safe, it actually locks the bolt. So if you want to open up your bolt, but you're in safe, all you have to do is push down this button, and then the bolt unlocks, just like it's supposed to, and stays locked in there. We also have a cocking indicator at the rear here. Just gonna check, make sure we're empty here. I'm gonna pull the trigger. And you can see that cocking indicator is no longer showing. So that's gonna show us when our action's ready to roll. Flipping it over to the other side. We've got a bolt release here, a dedicated one. I kind of prefer these over the ones that make you pull the trigger or do some sort of weird thing. Like this, on the Savages, you got to pull the trigger and push this thing on the right hand side. So that's kind of a pain in the butt. Whereas this is a lot easier. Push the button, out comes the bolt. Just to kind of show you guys the bolt itself. There you can see that three lug design. You can try to see that three lug here. Let me try to go flatter. There we go. You can see that three lug design there. It's a pretty solid bolt. A lot of metal going on here. It just contributes to a real solid feel when you're shooting this thing. It's got a nice squishy butt pad here, and it's a little bit more squishy in some places than others, just to kind of keep the rifle on your shoulder and keep it from flying off or twisting in your hands. And I think that's pretty much all I'm going to talk about for this rifle. I wanted to keep things nice and short and sweet. In terms of whether I would recommend this rifle, yeah, you know, if you've got right around that $700 to $1,000 that you want to spend on a rifle, this is a really good choice in that price range, and then you get a couple of extra features that you wouldn't get on a lot of the $300 to $500 rifles. So there are some cool things in it. One last thing I wanted to talk about that I think is the coolest thing on this rifle is this mag. Not because it's plastic, but because it's plastic, it's rotary, and it fits so nicely. It clicks in there nice and securely. There's not really any rattle to it. And it's, like, in terms of polymer, there's some bad plastic mags and there's some good plastic mags. I think this is one of the good ones. You can see how thick that plastic is. This thing's built like a tank, and it's very easy to load. You just kind of push that toggle off to the side, and then load in your rounds. This, being that this is a Magnum, this one holds three rounds, but in standard chamberings they hold four. Again, very easy to load. very secure. I love those plastic mags for how light they are and how durable they are. They're unlike a steel mag where a bend to the feed lips is going to ruin your feeding on them. These plastic lips are nice and secure. They're not going to bend. And if they break, it's because you just abused the heck out of it. So you're not likely to do that anytime. Trigger on this thing is excellent, as you can expect for a rifle in this class, and no spring or levers or anything like that required. So, great rifle. If you're in the market for a hunting rifle in the $700 range, definitely take a look at the Browning X-Bolt.